Sounds like you'll be having some fun of your own. It is my hope that by watching the...
Victory. Verlaine is the first to fall, but there will be more. Now, per the meat mandate, let us feast on the fall. Prepare the cave temple. It's a suitable place for a celebration.
Is clear.
An easy victory. Verlaine is the first to fall, but there will be more. Now, per the meat mandate, let us feast on the fallen. Prepare the cave temple. It's a suitable place for a celebration. Yeah. easy victory. Valain is the first to fall, but there will be more. Now, per the meat mandate, let us feast on the fallen. Prepare the cave temple. It's a suitable place for a celebration.
Split up!
Morgoth, the troops, half of them are dead. The other half
are dying, including us. This is poison. The villagers poisoned themselves to poison us.
What do you mean?
The meat mandate, you idiot. Elfirion knew she couldn't win on the field, but she'll still manage victory. To the Nereid Temple. Perhaps we can beg a cure.
Another sea.
Rise, my soldiers. Back to your bodies and take up arms.
Why do you command us from the ooze?
A powerful one, unknown to me, has stolen my bow. It invoked the right of theft and commanded we march against the Dominion.
By your command.
Yeah.
for the glimmers of the past I spoke of. Hopefully they will help us figure out how to put the Blackroot clan back to rest. Here's another scene. Let's watch.
Elfie, I can't do this. I'm scared. I don't want to die.
It's all right, Lynreel. The poison itself is slow. The black root will have cut our throats long before you felt its effects. Here, we'll drink it together, and I'll fight by your side till the end.
Until the end.
Now. To battle!
General Malgoth and the rest of the Black Root troops are almost upon us.
Then it's time. Distribute the Nereid Elixir and prepare to defend the village against the Black Root.
That plan is madness!
Silence, Glonia. Our sacrifice today will ensure our sister villages live on.
General Malgoth and the rest of the Black Root troops are almost upon us.
Go on if you must, but I'm going to remain here, for now at least.
That's the last of them, General. The village is clear.
Rise, my soldiers. Back to your bodies and take up arms.
Why do you command us from the ooze?
A powerful one, unknown to me, has stolen my... It invoked the right of theft, and commanded we march against the Dominion.
What a sacrifice! To think the villagers actually poisoned themselves in order to poison the Blackroot clan. It may be morbid, but it's also brilliant. Of course, that really doesn't help us return the Blackroot warriors to their graves, does it? From what I gathered, one of Naaman's servants has stolen General Malgoth's bow and compels the Blackroot clan to fight by the right of theft. What we need to do is steal the General's bow back, and then we can release him from his vows. We must rely on the scenes of the past. After being poisoned, General Malgoth went to the Nereid Temple. It's likely he died within. I suggest you go in and search for the General's remains. I'll continue searching for clues out here in the forest. Be wary in there. Nereids wield dangerous magic and can never be trusted. It's no surprise they helped the villagers in their suicidal plot. In fact, the Nereids probably consider General Malgoth's bow a prize. They will defend his remains. Desperation turns enemies into allies. The villagers knew General Molgoth and the Blackroot clan were going to attack, and they knew they couldn't win. Likely they asked the Nereids for help, and the Nereids convinced them this was the best course. Of course, Molgoth sought to unite all the Bosmer under his leadership. He led the Blackroot clan to conquer much of Valenwood during the Bosmer tribal rules. Then one day they just disappeared. No one knew what happened, until now. The Bosmer have always been free peoples, bound only to the Green. Rarely have the tribes united under singular leadership, although for a period many, like Molgoth, tried. Most of the so-called wars were not fought at all, but won by trickery. Yes, General Molgoth had traveled far and wide. He had seen the greatness that comes to those who conquer through military might. That you'd not heard of him is a tribute to the sacrifice of the Valain Bosmer. Because it's in their nature. Death amuses them, and all the more when they can manipulate people into bringing about their own demise. As distasteful as it may be, the Nereids are part of the natural order. I just try to stay away from them. As barbaric as it seems, many clans still lived by the old traditions during the Bosmer tribal wars. Mind you, they didn't consume the bodies of the dead because they enjoyed the taste. It was a matter of tradition. Apparently so, though the tactics they embrace sound more like a Nereid plot than something the villagers themselves might have come up with on their own. For General Molgoth, that's apparently the case. For all his ambition, he was still a staunch traditionalist. It's actually quite impressive that his sense of honor remains intact, even so many years after his death. I'd say this is a perverted case. The value that Molgoth placed on his bow alone may be enough for him to want it back. Or he may be using the right of theft as a more honorable justification for his new servitude. There was fear in his voice.
Thank you. you would steal that which has already been stolen, then enter the Shadowwood and seek it, though you will find only death. Come face me, Mr. Bowman. The bow is a boon to our army. You will not have it.
We're back in the Shadowwood. I had hoped not to visit here again. But if this is where he is holding the general's bow, then it's just as well. We need to find the Shade to get the bow back. I don't know. We'll have to search until we find it, though. In the meantime, however, do you recall the glimmers of the past we saw earlier? It seems those spirits are trapped here in the Shadowwood. We should release them. It's the Shadow Rifts that bind them here. From this side, you only need to touch the rifts to close them. That will release the spirits from their torment and weaken Naaman's grip on this place. If you'll focus on that, I'll search for the Shade. Good luck, and see you by the stones.
You will soon join us and fight at Morgoth's side. I hope you prepared for undead. Raven warned me about you, and I prepared. You will die, and then you will serve us.
Something's changed. I do not understand what's going on here.
That was a harrowing experience all around. I'm glad it's over. I hope we have succeeded in weakening Naaman's grasp on Valenwood as a whole. Only one thing remains. We must deal with the spirit of General Malgoth. Yes, and since you have succeeded in stealing it, it falls on you to invoke the right of theft with the General. Whatever you ask him, he will be compelled to do. The compassionate choice would be to release the general and his army, to allow them to return to their rest. But if you prefer, you might ask them instead to turn against Naaman and aid our forces in the fight for Valenwood. The choice is yours.
So it's true then? You have retrieved my bow from the Shade?
My father told me, you will find your bow in an animal's bone. Before it's even carved, you will see it. Mammoth's tusk. Extraordinarily difficult to make a good bow out of, but it was just like he said. I saw it, and I knew. What do you want? Death plays tricks. I thought you said leave, but that's not possible. We don't deserve rest. Not after what happened here. The Ooze is the only fitting place for us.
You released him. I think that was the right thing to do. I'm glad to know that at least some of the spirits here will be able to rest, though I am sorry for the villagers who remain trapped in the Shadowwood. We've done all we can here. But it's clear that Naaman still seeks to harm Valenwood, so our work is not finished. I suggest we spread out and search for signs of darkness. When Auriel wills it, I am certain the Green will bring us together again. Unless you have questions for me, I will soon be on my way. We should both search the forest for other signs of Naaman's corruption. I fear at some point we will have to confront Naaman himself. A spiritual prison of a sort. Bosmer who break their oath to the Green Pact go there when they die, to reflect for an eternity. There's a place called Owls, where we bring the bodies of Oathbreakers. Some think it's a physical link to the Ooze.